الحمد لله رب العالمين، صلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. We have read today from Surah Az-Zukhruf. And we have started the ayat where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَمَّا ضُرِبَ ابْنُ مَرْيَمَ مَثَلًا إِذَا قَوْمُكَ مِنْهُ يَصِدُّونَ. When the son of Mary was cited as an example, in argument, your people, O Prophet, broke into joyful applause. This ayah has a background story to it, that one named Zibari is a polytheist from the Quraysh, is a pagan. And when Rasulullah recited the verse from Surah Al-Anbiya, which reads, إِنَّكُمْ وَمَا تَعْبُدُونَ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ حَصَبُ جَهَنَّمُ أَنْتُمْ لَهَا وَارِدُونَ. That Rasulullah said this ayah, which means that you and whatever you worship besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are the fuel of Jahannam, are the fuel of Jahannam, you know, addressing the pagans of Quraysh. So when they heard this ayah, this man, this Zibari, I don't know what's it, how to pronounce his name, as Zibari, and or Zubari, he said that when your Rasulullah mentioned Isa alayhi salam in the Quran, and you mentioned the angels in the Quran, and both of them are worshipped, by people. So some worship the angels, and they think تعالى الله عن ذلك علوم كبيرة, the daughters of Allah. And they worship Isa alayhi salam, something his ilah, or he is the son of ilah. So are Isa and the angels are going to be the fuel of Jahannam? So they, when he said that, his people heard him, and they were joyful about that. They got an argument now. They can respond to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they thought that they overcame Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam with this argument. So that's why the ayah says, "Your people, O Prophet, broke into joyful applause." They thought that they won the argument. So Allah subhanahu wa taala then revealed the ayah, "Inna al-ladina sabaqat lahum minna al-husna, ulaika anha mubadun." لا يسمعون حسيسها وهم في ما اشتهت أنفسهم خالدون. Those to whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intended the best of rewards, those are far away from the hell of fire. So you have no argument, because Isa alayhi salam and the angels are righteous creatures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so they won't enter the fire. Allah intends what's best for them. But you, the pagans, and whatever you worship of idols, are going to be the fuel of Jahannam. So this is the background of this ayah. Now, Shaykh Mustafa. حصلوا جهنم. Exactly. So what is the guilt of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam or the angels that the polytheists worship them? Do they join this guilt? No. They are free of this guilt. They are the ones who worship Isa alayhi salam and the angels, and Isa and the angels are free of blame in this case. They have nothing to do with that. They are the polytheists who worship them. So it's not the fault of Isa alayhi salam or the angels alayhi salam. It's their fault, the pagans' fault. that they worship them. وقالوا أآلهتنا خير أم هو. They said, are our gods better or عيسى عليه السلام is better. سبحان الله. ما ضربوه لك إلا جدلا بل هم قوم خصمون. They only argue for the sake of argument. They are not seeking the truth. They don't know. They don't want to know the truth. But they are arguing for the sake of argument only. They are people given to arguing. They are prone to dispute. They only want to dispute. They don't seek the truth. So this is what the ayah means. إن هو إلا عبد أنعمنا عليه وجعلناه مثلا في بني إسرائيل. عيسى عليه السلام is only a servant of Allah. It's only a slave of Allah upon whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed his ni'mah by giving him prophethood and messengership. He's only a prophet and messenger from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he created him by saying be and he was. He created him without giving him a father, like we said before in other ayahs. إن هو إلا عبد من عمنا عليه وجعلناه مثلا لبني إسرائيل. And we have made him as an example to the children of Israel. That Allah سبحانه وتعالى created him miraculously without a father. He had only one mother. He created him from his mother. And we said before that the similitude of Isa عليه السلام is like Adam عليه السلام. Allah created him from dust and said to him be, and he was. And this is easy for Allah to do. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is emphasizing here to the polytheists and also to the people of the book, which are the Christians, that Isa عليه السلام is merely a prophet and a messenger from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not more than that. Not more than that. So don't raise him above his position and make him ilah or make him son of ilah. Don't raise Isa alayhi salam above his position as a prophet and a messenger of Allah and one of the nearest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَوْ نَشَاءُ لَجَعَلْنَا مِنْكُمْ مَلَائِكَةً فِي الْأَرْضِ يَخْلُفُونَ. And had we wished, we would have replaced you with angels. So we would have replaced you with angels on earth. So we will take you away and put angels on earth. And they will be successing one another. And this is in response to those who say that the angels are the daughters of Allah. And they think because they inhabit the heavens, so that they are the daughters of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what they think, because they inhabit the heavens. And people are inhabiting the earth. So he said, the angels inhabiting the heaven doesn't give them that status. You know, doesn't make them, you know, special creatures that you would ascribe, you know, that they are daughters for Allah. We could put the angels on earth. We could replace you with the angels and make the angels inhabit the earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills, you know, does what he wills. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are creatures of Allah. يَفْعَلُونَ مَا يُؤْمَرُونَ. They will carry out the commands of Allah without disobedience. They will do whatever they are told by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they are creatures of Allah. They are not daughters of Allah wa niyabu lillah. تعالى الله عما يصفون. So, and then Allah سبحانه وتعالى is talking about سيدنا عيسى عليه السلام again. وإنه لعلم للساعة فلا تمترون بها واتبعون. That verily indeed عيسى عليه السلام is a sign of the hour. So his second coming, he's talking about the second coming of Isa alayhi salam, when he will come to earth, and that coming will be surely a sign of the nearness of the hour. Qudumuhu of the day of judgment. Yes, as-sa'ah. Qudumu Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, عندما ينزله الله من الأرض سيكون علامة قوية أو كبرى من علامات الساعة من أشراط الساعة، فلا تنذرون بها. So do not doubt that and follow me. So this is as Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم addressing the pagans of Quraysh, right? And also the people of the book indirectly. هذا صراط مستقيم. And this is a straight path. ولا يصدنكم الشيطان إنه لكم عدو مبين. Then Allah سبحانه وتعالى is also reminding those pagans that if you keep rejecting the message of Allah, if you keep disbelieving in the message of Allah and in Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, then you are basically like the shaitan. Basically like the shaitan, you're refusing the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you're refusing to accept the message of Allah. And you know that shaitan is a clear enemy to you. Is a clear enemy to you. So do not follow shaitan, do not listen to the shaitan, do not let him turn you away from the straight path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا يَصُدَّنَّكُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ إِنَّهُ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ مُّبِينٌ ولما جاء عيسى للبينات قال قد جئتكم بالحكمة وليبين لكم بعض الذي تختلفون فيه. When عيسى عليه السلام came, he said that verily I came to you with wisdom. And what is the wisdom? الإنجيل. الإنجيل that Allah سبحانه وتعالى has given him. That's the wisdom that عيسى came with. قد جئتكم بالحكمة وليبين لكم بعض الذي تختلفون فيه and to clarify to you matters that you differ with one another about. So clarifying what they were differing about and bringing them the wisdom which is the gospel, the Injil of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he has given Isa alayhi salam. And some of the differences that they differ about, they used to distort the Torah. They used to write the Torah with their own hands and they said that this is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They used فَوَيْلُ لِلَّذِينَ يَكْتُبُونَ الْكِتَابَ بِأَيْدِيهِمْ ثُمَّ يَقُولُونَ هَذَا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ فَوَيْلُ لَهُمْ مِمَّا كَتَبَتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَوَيْلُ لَهُمْ مِمَّا يَكْسِبُونَ. They write the book with their own hands and they say this is from Allah while it was not from Allah. They lie about that.
Shaitan.
Yes. Yeah. So woe to them for what they write with their own hands. And woe to them for what they are gaining from that. And then he says, فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ سَيْدْنَا عِيسَى عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِعُونَ Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and obey me. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and obey me. هذا إن الله هو ربي وربكم فاعبدوه هذا صراط مستقيم. Verily Allah is my Lord and your Lord. So worship Him alone. So worship Him alone. And this is a straight path. And this verse, يعني سبحان الله, it is even found in the current Bible. You will find this verse in the current Bible. It says clearly that God is my Lord and your Lord. إن الله ربي وربكم فاعبدوه هذا صراط مستقيم. They even have it in their Bible that when Isa was subjected to the cross, as they believe, he was crying. He was asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to rescue him, to rescue him. Oh Allah, oh Allah, why have you forsaken me? This is what is written in the Bible. Because he was calling on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to rescue him. So how do you believe, how could you believe in someone who is a human and he is calling upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How do you believe in him as God or otherwise or deity? Subhanallah. وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ رَبِّي وَرَبُّكُمْ فَاعْبُدُونَ هَذَا صِرَاطٌ مُسْتَقِيمٌ فاختلف الأحزاب من بينهم فويل للذين ظلموا من عذاب يوم أليم. And then the sects and the denominations that they differed with one another about the nature of Isa alayhi salam. as we said, some regard him as God, and some regard him as son of God, and some regard him as one of three. Those who have differed amongst themselves, فاختلف الأحزاب من بينهم, so they differed among themselves, woe to those who are the wrongdoers, وويل للذين ظلموا, warning them of a painful torment on a terrible day, which is the day of قيامة, the day of قيامة, وويل للذين ظلموا من عذاب يوم أليم هل ينظرون إلا الساعة أن تأتيهم بغتة وهم لا يشعرون. Do they wait for the hour to come to them suddenly and without them being aware of it? Do they wait for the hour? SubhanAllah. So why don't they believe right away? الأخلاء يومئذ بعضهم لبعض عدو إلا المتقين. You know, on the day of judgment, close friends would be enemies of one another. And there is an exception, except for the righteous. The righteous will be close friends, will stay close friends. But the wicked will be enemies to one another, even though they seem to be close friends in this dunya. But in the hereafter, they will be enemies to one another. وَلَخِ اللَّهُ يَوْمَئِذٍ بَعْضُهُمْ لِبَعْضٍ عَدُوٌّ إِلَّا الْمُتَّقِينَ يَا عِبَادِ لَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْكُمْ وَلَا أَنْتُمْ تَحْزَنُونَ. O my servants, there will be no fear for you, nor will you grieve. المتقين, he is describing the righteous now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يَا عِبَادِ, يَا عِبَادِ بِالْيَا, وَيَا عِبَادِ without يَا. Two different Qur'ans. يَا عِبَادِ لَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْكُمُ الْيَوْمَ وَلَا أَنْتُمْ تَحْزَنُونَ. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِآيَاتِنَا وَكَانُوا مُسْلِمِينَ. Those who believed in our signs and they were submissive to Allah, they submitted to Allah, they were basically Muslims. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِآيَاتِنَا وَكَانُوا مُسْلِمِينَ. أُدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةَ أَنْتُمْ وَأَزْوَاجُكُمْ تحضرون. Enter paradise, you and your spouses, you and your believing spouses, in the Jannah, تحضرون means joyful, and this joy will appear on your faces as well. When someone looks at you, he will feel that you are happy. The happiness will appear on your faces. تحضرون, this is من الحضر, من السرور الذي يظهر على الوجه. أنتم وأزواجكم تحضرون. أنتم وأزواجكم تحضرون. يطاف عليهم بصحاف من ذهب وأكواب. So there will be golden trays and golden plates and golden cups that will go around to them. You know, the wildan will serve them that. They will have them service from the youngsters, the eternal youngsters, as we talk about the Tufa'alim, Mu'adam, and Mukhaddadun, the Aqwab, and Mu'adariqa, Yahsin, and Na'im. Right?
So
they will serve them. They will wait on them. They will serve them with trays of gold, with plates of gold, and with cups of gold. Well, Aqwab is containers that don't have handles. وفيها ما تشتهيه الأنفس وتلذ الأعين وأنتم فيها خالدون. And in the paradise, in the Jannah, there is everything that you desire, everything that the soul desires. وتلذ الأعين, and everything that the eyes are delighted in. You will find therein everything that the soul desires. And whatever the eyes are delighted in, everything. فيها ما لا عين رأت ولا أذن سمعت ولا خطر على قلب بشر. Right? Therein, there's everything that the eye has never seen, nor has the ear ever heard of, nor has crossed the mind of any human being. Everything imaginable and unimaginable. سبحان الله. وأنتم فيها خالدون. And you are therein forever, for eternity. You will inhabit the Jannah forever. وأنتم فيها خالدون العمر العمل من أهل الجنة. وتلك الجنة التي ورثتموها بما كنتم تعملون. And that is the paradise that you have inherited by way of your righteous deeds. This is what you did in this dunya, righteous deeds. Your reward is al-Jannah. You will be admitted to al-Jannah. وأما العمل من أهل الجنة يا رب. فأما أنا نسألك الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل ونعوذ بك من النار وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل. لكم فيها فاكهة كثيرة منها تأكلون. Therein there will be abundant fruits, every kind of fruits. منها تأكلون. From it you eat whatever you choose to eat from this fruit, you eat. You pick and eat. And we said before that when one picks a fruit from a tree, another one comes out. Another one comes out. It never ends. The bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I think this is enough for today, talking about the Jannah, because the other part talks about the fire of hell. And I think we are taking a long time in this lesson. What do you think? Should we shorten the...
You can ask everybody.
Yeah.
Mashwara.
Yeah, mashwara, yes. What do you think? We prolong these thoughts or is it you have not the time that...
I'm sorry, we can see everybody sitting and listening nicely. Yeah. That means they want to continue.
Yeah.
Well, for somebody who has got a job or something.
Yes, that's what I'm saying.
They can leave. Whoever wants to leave.
Yes.
But
somebody who likes to stay, will stay.
Yes. Yes. So, I don't want to prolong.
Yeah, this is enough.
So beautiful.
For 7:33.
15 minutes is okay?
15 minutes is short.
Is good?
For sure. 10 minutes, half an
hour. Half an hour is okay.
Okay, alhamdulillah. So we'll continue, inshallah?
Inshallah.
Okay. Alhamdulillah. إِنَّ الْمُجْرِمِينَ فِي عَذَابِ جَهَنَّمَ خَالِدُونَ. The criminals, the guilty, the wicked are in the torment of Jahannam forever. خَالِدُونَ وَإِلَّا بِاللَّهِ وَالْمَجْرَ مِنَ
النَّارِ.
آمين. لَا يُفَتَّرُ عَنْهُ وَهُمْ فِيهِ مُبْلِسُونَ. And the torment or the punishment of Allah will not be lessened for them. It will not be decreased. And then they will be covered with despair. They will be covered with despair. Al-yas, ya'isun. Wa hum fihi mublisun. In the torment of Allah. Fi adabi Allahi mublisun. With despair. Wa ma zalamnahum. ولكن كانوا هم الظالمين. And we have not wronged them. Rather, they were the ones who were the wrongdoers. وما ظلمناهم. ولكن كانوا هم الظالمين. هم ظلموا أنفسهم. هم ظلموا أنفسهم. They wronged themselves by not heeding the advice of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, by not believing in Allah and His messengers, and by not being obedient in this life. And that's why they wronged themselves. And Allah did not wrong them. ولا يظلم ربك Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never does wrongdo anybody. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never does that. Never oppresses anybody unjustly. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَقَالُوا يَا مَالِكُ لِيَقْضِ عَلَيْنَا رَبُّكَ قَالَ إِنَّكُمْ مَكِثُونَ وَعَلَيْهُ بِاللَّهِ. And then they called Malik, who is one of the keepers of the fire of hell. He is the main keeper of the fire of hell, alayhi salam. Malik. And they called Malik and they said, oh Malik, let Allah finish us off. Let Allah make us die from what they see of the torment, from what they see of the adhan. They would call and ask Malik alayhi salam to make dua, to make them die. قَالَ إِنَّهُمْ مَاكِثُونَ. He said, no, you will remain there in the adhan forever and you will not die. لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا. They are not going to die in it, nor they will actually live, a decent life. عذاب, it's a torment. It's an eternal torment, eternal عذاب. والعياذ بالله. قال إنكم ماكثون. لقد جئناكم بالحق. ولكن أكثركم للحق قائلون. We have come to you with the truth, but most of you were hateful of the truth. You hated the truth. You didn't want the truth. You were resentful of the truth. You did not accept the truth. لقد جئناكم بالحق ولكن أكثركم للحق كارهون أم أبرموا أمرا فإنا مبرمون. Or are they marking something? Are they concocting some kind of conspiracy? Then Allah will plan as well for them. أم أبرموا أمرا فإنا مبرمون أم يحسبون أنا لا نسمع سرهم ونجواهم بلى ورسلنا لديهم يكتبون. Or do they think that we do not hear what they talk, you know, between one another secretly, and what evil thoughts they have? We know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sirra wa akhfa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows every secret, and even which is even hidden more than the secret. He knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ya'lamu sirra wa akhfa. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what you converse with one another secretly, knows the evil thoughts you have as well. So don't think that Allah doesn't know. Allah knows, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He is all-knowing. بَلَى وَرُسُلُنَا لَدَيْهِمْ يَكْتُبُونَ. And also our angels, about the knowledge of Allah, our angels are writing what these people are conversing with one another secretly. They are writing, they have a record. The angels have, keep a record of that as well. To face you on the Day of Judgment, to face those, they will find a record of their deeds and of their sayings. Everything that they do in this dunya, it is recorded. And that record will be presented to them on the Day of Judgment. Yes. قُلْ إِنْ كَانَ لِلرَّحْمَنِ وَلَدٌ فَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْعَابِدِينَ. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to tell them that if the most compassionate has a son, then I will be the first to worship him. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not have a son, alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, الذي لم يتخذ ولدا. You know, praise be Allah that He has not taken a son, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Amma yasifun. So He's saying that if Allah has a son, which He does not have, then I will be the first to worship that son. But this never happens, so the consequence never happens either.
لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ.
لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ. وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not beget, nor was He begotten. سُبْحَانَ رَبِّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ رَبِّ الْعَرْشِ عَمَّا يَصِفُونَ. Glorified is the Lord of the heavens and the earth, the Lord of the throne, far above what they claim. SubhanAllah. And this is a glorification of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he is glorified. It is unbecoming for Allah to have a son. وَمَا يَنْبَغِي لِلرَّحْمَنِ أَنْ يَتَّخِذَ وَلَدًا إِنْ كُلُّ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ إِلَّا آتِي الرَّحْمَنِ عَبْدًا. You know, every creature of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in heavens and in earth will come to Allah as a slave, as a servant. We are all the slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَذَرْهُمْ يَقُوضُوا وَيَلْعَبُوا حَتَّى يُلَاقُوا يَوْمَهُمْ الَّذِي يُوعَدُونَ. So let them rejoice, let them play until they face the day which they are promised. And it's the Day of Judgment. وَهُوَ الَّذِي فِي السَّمَاءِ إِلَهٌ وَفِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَهٌ وَهُوَ الْحَكِيمُ الْعَلِيمُ. It is He who is the only deity, the only God, in heavens and on earth. وَهُوَ الْحَكِيمُ الْعَلِيمُ. He is the all-wise, all-knowing. So He is إله in the heavens, and He is إله on earth. هُوَ اللَّهُ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَفِي الْأَرْضِ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ. وتبارك الذي له ملك السماوات والأرض وما بينهما وعنده علم الساعة وإليه ترجعون. And blessed is He who has the sovereignty and the kingdom of the heavens and the earth and what's in between, and the only one who has the knowledge of the hour, with him is the knowledge of the hour. Only, no one knows the time of the hour except for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَهُوَ أَحَدُ الْمَغِيدَاتِ الْخَمْسِ. عِلْمُ السَّاعَةِ is one of the five unseen things that only Allah knows subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they are mentioned in Surah Luqman. In the last ayah of Surah Luqman. Can you recite it, Shaykh? With Allah is the knowledge of the hour. This is one of the five unseen things that only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. وَلَا يَمْشُكُ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ الشَّفَاعَةِ إِلَّا مَنْ شَهِدَ بِالْحَقِّ وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ. And those whom they worship besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they do not possess intercession. They cannot intercede on their behalf except by the permission of Allah, and that intercession will only be given to those who attest to the truth knowingly. إِلَّا مَنْ شَهِدَ بِالْحَقِّ وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ. وَلَا بَيْشْ آية الكرسي. Who is going to intercede with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except the one whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given permission to intercede? No one can intercede except by the leave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَهُمْ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهِ فَأَنَّا يُفْتَقُونَ. And if you ask them, O Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who created them? They will surely say, Allah. Then how would they go astray? If they already confess that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created them, then why don't they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instead of worshiping the idols? Who are not even aware. They don't speak, they don't, you know, hear, they don't, subhanAllah, why do you worship stones or idols from made up from dates or from anything? SubhanAllah. وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَهُمْ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهُ فَأَنَّى يُؤْفَكُونَ. وَقِيلِهِ يَا رَبِّ إِنَّ هَؤُلَاءِ قَوْمٌ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he said, Oh my Lord, these people do not believe. Those people are insisting on disbelief. They won't believe. وقيل يا رب إن هؤلاء قوم لا يؤمنون فاصفح عنهم وقل سلام. So bear with them and say peace. And this peace, not a greeting of peace, it's a peace of departing, meaning a peace of leaving. Leave them. Say salam to them and leave them. فاصفح عنهم, bear with them, leave them, and say salam, a salam of departing, not a salam of greeting. فَاصْفَحْ عَنْهُمْ وَقُلْ سَلَامٌ فَسَوْفَ يَعْلَمُونَ. They will come to know on the day of judgment. And this is a threat. فَسَوْفَ يَعْلَمُونَ. And they will come to know on the day of judgment what their own hands gave them. هذا والله ورسوله أعلم. جزاكم الله خيرا. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام
ورحمة
الله وبركاته.
بارك
الله فيكم.
جزاكم الله خيرا. أجمعين. الحمد لله نتدارس كتاب الله في بيت الله. الحمد لله.